Building a website isn't just about how it looks. It's about making it usable for everyone. That's what accessibility is all about. Accessibility improves the user experience, but it also helps your site reach more people and build trust. That's why following global accessibility guidelines, like the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, or WCAG for short, is so important. At its core, accessibility means designing websites that everyone can navigate, interact with, and understand, including those who rely on assistive tools like screen readers, keyboard navigation, or magnification software. But accessibility isn't just about the tools. It's about removing barriers that make it difficult for some users to access content. Let's look at an inaccessible site. There are a few things here that make this site hard to use for some people. The text is hard to read because it blends too much into the background, which makes it difficult for users with low vision or color blindness to see clearly. The main button just says, "Click here." And for users who rely on screen readers, they may not understand what this button does out of context. And finally, the form fields can't be filled out using just a keyboard, making it impossible for users who can't use a mouse to navigate and complete the form. Now, let's make it more accessible. First, we'll add an overlay over the image and darken the background color so the text is easier to read. Next, we'll update the button to say something more descriptive, like download the guide, so screen reader users know exactly what the button does. Finally, we'll ensure that the form is fully navigable with a keyboard. With these changes, we're on the right track to creating a more accessible and inclusive website. Now that we've covered what accessibility is, let's explore how Webflow's tools make building accessible sites easier. First, the audit panel. The audit panel identifies common accessibility issues on your page and provides instructions on how to fix them. Let's take a look at an example. In Webflow, we can see the status of the audit panel. A red square indicates a new critical error on your current page. If we click in, we can see there's an instance of missing alt text. Alt text describes the appearance or the function of an image on the page. This is picked up by screen readers and search engines, so they can understand the content of the image. So let's fix it. We can click on it, and it takes us to that image with the missing alt text. From there, we can address this by following the instructions. We can choose whichever option works best for our situation. And with that, we've addressed all of the audits on this page. And the audit panel doesn't just find missing alt text. It can flag duplicate element IDs, skipped heading levels, and instances of non-descriptive links. Addressing these not only helps with accessibility, but also the SEO, since these help search engines read your site's content. So that's the audit panel. Next one. The vision preview tool gives an approximate simulation of how your site looks to different visual impairments that affect a large percentage of the population. Here's an example of a design that relies on the distinction between red and green icons. But when you simulate your site with red-green color blindness, the meaning is lost, making it much harder to tell the icons apart. There are many ways to address this, but a general best practice is to convey meaning with not just color. Even adding different symbols for each icon can make them more distinguishable. By using the Vision Preview tool, you can make design choices that improve accessibility, ensuring your site is both inclusive and easy to use for everyone. Next up, we have the Color Contrast tool. This is built into the Typography Color Picker in the Style panel. Toggling the eye icon shows the range where I hit AA and AAA contrast ratios between my foreground color, that's my text, and any solid background color. Currently, it's failing in contrast, so let's just adjust the color to meet a minimum AAA contrast ratio. That's much better. So that's the color contrast tool. Last thing we'll cover is Webflow's accessibility checklist. Whether you're building your site or refining it for launch, Webflow's accessibility checklist not only helps you track your progress, but it also provides tips and detailed insights into each best practice, empowering you to consistently design with accessibility in mind. And that's it. We barely scratched the surface of web accessibility and the tools Webflow provides to help you make your sites accessible. We have more tips and detailed guides for making your site accessible over on Webflow University and the Webflow Help Center. And again, be sure to reference the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines to learn more. But that's a quick overview of accessibility on the web.